I want to welcome now Yohanan Plesner, the president of the Israel Democracy Institute. He's a former member of Israel's Knesset for the Kadima party. Good day, sir. Prime Minister Netanyahu has warned that the war against Hamas will take time and it will be hard. Is the prime minister preparing the Israeli people for a prolonged conflict?
Yes, it will take time. Israel just experienced yesterday a horrific day. This is the Israeli equivalent of our 9/11. In the early morning, Saturday, barbaric Hamas terrorists attacked dozens of Israeli villages and towns and killed mothers and kids and grandmothers and has taken dozens of them hostages. Israel now needs to First of all, defend its population and exact a very dear price from Hamas. The extremists throughout the region are observing very closely and want to understand what will transpire. And Israel, alongside with its ally, obviously the United States, needs to demonstrate that those who kill innocent civilians unprovoked are going to pay a dear price for that. And of course, this will take time. Hamas is perpetrating war crimes and situating all its capabilities within its own civilian population. So there will be civilian casualties in order to erode, undermine, and destroy the Hamas capabilities. And it's going to be tough and long, but Israelis across the spectrum are united and understand that it's absolutely essential if we want to remain strong and powerful in this region.
Strong and powerful, but you know, I mean, is it worth all the collateral damage in terms of your, are you prepared to accept all the civilian casualties that come with such a protracted conflict?
Look,
is that acceptable?
Look, there's no other option. Israelis were stormed and with hundreds of terrorists attacking all of our towns and villages, brutally assassinating Israelis, taking dozens of captives, including torturing young girls, young boys, grandmothers, Holocaust survivors. I mean, this is a brutal attack. We were surprised, and now we have to take the initiative. We have to obviously ensure that our hostages are being released, and that the Hamas capabilities are eroded in a way that they won't be able to perpetrate such violent and barbaric acts for many years.
Do Israelis still have confidence in their government and in its ability to keep them safe?
Look, no doubt that now Israel needs a national unity government. We had our own internal differences. I've been on CNN speaking about our differences around Israeli democracy, but on Israeli security and on the fact that Hamas has a clear a goal of annihilating and destroying the state of Israel, and on that we're all united. And I wouldn't be surprised if this is also a scheme. Hamas is obviously strongly supported by Iran, that wants to undermine the American Saudi deal in the region by leading to escalation between Israel and Hamas and making such a deal impossible. So this is probably with Iranian support and part of a broader Iranian scheme. And this needs to be pushed back very strongly with much confidence to make it very clear that the moderate forces in the region will overcome.
Okay, now a final question for you. You know, this is obviously a major, massive security challenge for Israel, and everyone obviously is still in the thick of it, and it's too early to tell how all of this will evolve. But let's look long-term, if we can. Can you envisage an alternative future, however difficult and incredibly hard things are right now? Because this situation is simply unsustainable.
Yes, you're absolutely right that we have to look into the, you know, describe a future vision and then try to work towards it. A future vision cannot include a barbaric, murderous Hamas regime just on Israel's back door. It's not, you know, somewhere on the other side of the ocean. It's just on our backyard, a barbaric regime that has a clear, defined, explicit goal of annihilating the state of Israel. And yesterday, they actually tried to implement it de facto. So any future vision includes a leadership of the Palestinians in Gaza, about 2 million Palestinians, that is not a leadership that wants to murder Jews and Israelis, but a leadership that has some kind of a vision of coexistence. And then, of course, we can live in peace together.
All right, coexistence. Yohanan Plesner, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.